University of San Francisco Business 305, Principles of Finance, Goldman Sachs. Take 12, Team Zoe.
Hi, everyone. Today we're talking about Goldman Sachs.
Hi, I'm Wenxian.
My name is Chantu.
My name is Zoe.
And our recommendation is sell because the intrinsic value is less than the current price. The overview of the presentation, first we're going to talk about the background of the Goldman Sachs, and then we'll talk about the peers in the industry, and we'll talk about the analyze. Finally, we talk about the stock valuation. The values of the innovative approach. Buyers' interests always come first. Goal is to provide superior returns to the shareholders. The value of diversity, teamwork, and service excellence. Security and resiliency. Brief introduction. The bank is leading international investment bank, broad range of investment, consulting and financial services to the world, with a large number of the multi-industry clients, one of the oldest and largest investment bank in the world, headquartered in the New York and has office in Tokyo, London and Hong Kong, with 41 offices and 23 countries. On June 7, 2000, the Goldman Sachs Group ranked 78. And on July 19, 2018, the Goldman Sachs ranked 215. Now, this is the leadership of the Goldman Sachs. The core services, the investment bank, investment holding, transaction investment, and asset management.
This is a table for Goldman Sachs total sets to compare and contrast with other banks. The first one is JP Morgan, BOA, Wells Fargo, Citigroup. The last one is Goldman Sachs. It only has $0.9 trillion dollars. On the SWOT analysis, there are four parts of it. The first one is trends. High level, I'm going to explain the high level of customer satisfaction. High level customer satisfaction, the company with its delicate customer relationship management department has able to achieve a high level of customer satisfaction among present customer and a good brand equity among the potential customers. On the weakness part, the not very good at product demand forecasting leading to higher rate of missed opportunities compared to its competitors. One of the reasons why the days inventory is high compared to its competitors is that Goldman Sachs is not very good at demand forecasting, thus end up keeping higher inventory both in house and in channel. On the opportunity part, I'm going to when the new customer from online China. Over the past few years, the company has invested some of money into the online platform. This investment has opened new sales channel for Goldman Sachs. On the threatened part, there's no regular supply of innovative products. Over the years, the company has developed numerous products, but those are often response to the developed by other players. On the financial condition part, we said that ROA is 1.09%, ROE is 7.07%, and profit, like the numbers show on the table, and we can compare contrast with other numbers with the like WFC peer group industry average. The condition of it, the overall of them, we think is below average. And also the equity ratio growth rate The number is under the average, so the overall of it is below average. The situation of their financial is not very good. On the perpetuity model, intrinsic value is 177.5. We got the 8% medium range, and the discount it should be 13.4%. On Golden Brook model, 1% of it is $187.14. The discount should be 8.7%. And the multiple approach, we got the 13, 14, and the 15, and the stock value should be 183.4. The discount we calculated is 10.5%. On the DCF, discount the cash flow, the stock value we on the median 8% should be 200.48. Interest value is 200.48, and then current price is 205. The discount should be 2.2%. On the weight stock valuation, we got the all of them and the weight for 10%, 10%, 30%, 15%. The intrinsic value by weight is 191.07. It almost like $191.1. So its discount is 7.2%. Is that we suggest that you sell the stock.
All right, I'll stick around if